Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create stunning retro portrait posters. Open a photo of someone or something that you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. Before we begin, to ensure that your results will look similar to mine, let's check its size and resolution by going to Image and Image Size. Make sure your document is 150 pixels per inch. If your document's aspect ratio isn't in a vertical portrait mode, open your Crop tool and open the list of crop presets. Click Width, Height, and Resolution. Type into the resolution field 150 for the pixels per inch. Leave the width and height empty. Drag the corners or the edges of the bounding box in or out. I'll cancel the cropping since I already cropped it earlier. Next, we'll separate our subject from its background. There are many ways to do this, but for this example, click any of the selection tools and click Select and Mask. I did an in-depth tutorial on Select and Mask, so if you'd like to watch it, I provided its link in this video's description. Choose Color Aware if your subject is on a simple background, or click Object Aware if your subject is on a complex background. Click Select Subject and check Decontaminate Colors, which will essentially prevent the background colors from leaching into the edges of our subject. Output it to a new layer with Layer Mask and click OK. We'll convert our visible subject into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively and replace it with a different image without having to redo any of the effects. To do this, click the icon at the upper right and click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter, Artistic, and Poster Edges. The edge thickness is 0, the edge intensity is 2, and the posterization is 1. Go back to Filter, Artistic, and Cutout. The number of levels is 8, the edge simplicity is 5, and the edge fidelity is 2. Double-click the icon next to Cutout to open its blending mode. Change it from Normal to Lighten. Next, we'll place a black background behind our subject. Collapse the smart filters to save a little space in the Layers panel. Control or Command click the New Layer icon to make a new layer below the subject. We'll fill the empty layer with black, but before we do, let's check our foreground and background colors. If they aren't black and white, press D. If they're reversed, press X. To fill our empty layer with black, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Next, we'll add a thin white line surrounding the inner perimeter of our poster. Double-click anywhere on the black layer to open its layer style window. Click Stroke. If the color box isn't black, click it, and when the color picker opens, pick black. The size is 21 pixels, and the position is inside. The blend mode is normal, and the opacity is 100%. Click Inner Glow. The color is white, the blend mode is normal, and the opacity is 100%. The source is edge, the choke is 100%, and the size is also 21 pixels. If you want a thicker outline, make the size 22. The contour is linear, and the range is 50%. Next, we'll add a large circular shape of color behind our subject. First, let's save some more space. Make a new layer. Open the Ellipse tool, and at the top, choose Shape. click the Fill box, and click the Color Picker icon. Pick a bright color for your circular shape. Click the Stroke box. If the No Stroke symbol isn't there, click its icon here. Place your cursor in the center and drag the tool out to approximately this size. If you want to adjust its size, go to a corner and press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out. To center it, open your Move tool and press Ctrl or Command A to select the entire document, and at the top, click the Align Vertical Centers icon. Then, deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. Hide the path by pressing Ctrl or Command H. Next, we'll add a retro bar gradient. Make a new layer and open the Gradient tool. Press D to default the colors to black and white, respectively. Choose Gradient and open your list of gradient presets. Click the black to white preset and make sure the linear gradient icon is active. Place your cursor at the bottom and press and hold the Shift key as you drag it to the top. Then release. Pressing Shift kept the gradient perfectly vertical. Convert it into a smart object. Go to Filter, Sketch, and Halftone Pattern. The pattern type is Line, the contrast is 50, and I'll make the size 8. Feel free to make the size whatever you like. Hover your cursor between the gradient layer and the circle layer. Press and hold Alt or Option. When your cursor changes into a clipping mask icon, click it. This restricts the gradient to the inside shape of the circle. Another way to clip it is to go to Layer and create Clipping Mask. Change the Blend Mode to Darken. I'll reduce the gradient's opacity to 30%, but feel free to adjust it to whatever looks good to you. Next, we'll add text. Make the top layer active and make a new layer above it. Open your Horizontal Type tool. Press X to invert your foreground and background colors so our text will be white. Open your Type Picker and pick a font for your poster. We'll adjust its size in a moment. I'll make its aliasing sharp and center alignment. Click above the circle and type out your text. To adjust its size as well as the amount of space between all the characters, known as tracking, highlight your text and click the Character Paragraph icon. You could also go to Window and Character. Place your cursor over the Size icon and drag it to the right or left. To adjust its tracking, place your cursor over the Tracking icon and drag it. Then, at the top, click the check mark. To center it, again, press Ctrl or Command A to select the document. Open your Move tool and click the Align Vertical Centers icon. Then deselect it. To raise it up or down, press and hold the Shift key as you press the up or down arrow on your keyboard to move it 10 pixels at a time. To add the bottom text, press Ctrl or Command J to make a copy of the top text and make the bottom text active. Before we drag it to the bottom of the poster, make sure Auto Select isn't checked. This will prevent other layers from becoming active when we click on our document. Press and hold the Shift key as you drag the text to the bottom. Double-click the bottom text layer to highlight it and type out your new text. If the bottom of your subject's colors and/or contrast makes the text difficult to see, I'll show you how to resolve it. But before I do, let's add a drop shadow to our subject. Make your subject active and make a copy of it. Double-click an empty area of the copies layer to open its layer style window. Click Drop Shadow. copy these settings. Notice the drop shadow is overlapping the white border, which we don't want. To resolve this, convert the subject with the drop shadow into a smart object and scroll down to the circle. Control or Command click the thumbnail to select it. Click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask of the circle next to the active layer. As I mentioned in this example, since the bottom of the subject is making the text difficult to see, I'll show you how to resolve it. Double-click the bottom text layer to open its layer style window. Click Drop Shadow. The blend mode is Multiply or Normal, the color is black, and the opacity is 100%. Use Global Light is unchecked. For this image, I'll make the angle 50 degrees to match the drop shadow of my subject. I'll make the distance 6 pixels since the text I'm using is very thin. Feel free to increase the amount for your text. The size is 0 pixels, which keeps the sharpness of the drop shadow. Double-click the thumbnail of the subject to open its source. Make a new layer and open the gradient tool. Open the gradient presets and click the black to transparent thumbnail. Place your cursor below the document and press and hold the Shift key as you drag it up approximately this much. Go to the layer mask next to your subject and press and hold Alt or Option as you drag a copy of it up over the gradient's layer mask. If you see this message, click Yes to replace the layer mask. Double-click the gradient layer to open the gradient fill window. Adjust the scale to tighten up the gradient and drag it down. I'll reduce its opacity to 50%, but you can make yours whatever you want. Close the Smart Object source file, and when you see this message, click Yes to save the changes. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.